Asbury Park.
I was good off the field. I was good in the parking lot. I was a good player in the parking lot and in the sand lot, but the minute I got the uniform on and on the field, I don't know, something happened. I'm not sure why.
Bruce and I met in a Hollywood recording studio back in 91. We were both making albums. We hit it off.
I played everything I see. I played third base, which I used to love to play. I played a little bit of shortstop.
Soon we were sharing our Jersey roots, our love of music, memories of the same places. Freehold, Long Beach Island, Belmar, and oh yeah, those trips to Yankee Stadium. Our heroes were Maris and Mantle, the M&M boys. The summer of 61 was like a great movie that never ended.
I remember following Maris chasing the home run record that year, like home run by home run. I can remember counting them off, you know. It was just, I was 11.
Bruce's song Glory Days has been running like a loop in my head lately. I saw myself on the fields of my youth. It was beautiful.
The first verse is about baseball, and it came out of an actual incident. I met a school friend. I was walking into a bar one afternoon, and he was walking out, and hadn't seen each other since probably high school. And he was on this team I was on in Babe Ruth League, the Braves. We were the Braves. And bumped into one another and said, hey, let's go back inside and have a drink. And that whole first verse, word for word, sort of happened, you know. So I played baseball from when I was 6 to when I was 15, to the year that I picked the guitar up. But I was always bad. I was always terrible. With the exception of I had one good season. I think it was I was 12. It was opening day, and I got up, and I hit a double. And I was terrific the rest of the year. But the breakthrough only lasted for me 1 year because I did so well that they brought me up to Babe Ruth League, and there were guys that could throw real curves.
We grew up about 35 miles apart. Bruce is a little older, but our stories sound the same. I played Little League too. Then just like Bruce, I picked up a guitar and my world changed.
I remember I got up at the plate and Lance Rowe was pitching. Lance, I know you're out there somewhere. And Lance fires one straight at me. And I leap back, which then, of course, immediately curves across the plate. Strike! And I resorted to my terrible ways.
Over to first. He's out of there.
The next year, Bruce bought his first guitar for $18. Good investment. Coming up on seventh inning stretch.
I was desperate to find something that I could do.
Bruce Springsteen makes a fateful decision.
They're looking for you to play. Hold on, tell them I'm sick. You know,
those clouds look like they could open up at any time. Hey, a rainout could be a good thing. At least for one insane individual named Pat DiNizio. What am I doing here? What if I get the call from Sparky? I'm getting way too edgy. Think of simple things, happy times, like hanging out with Bruce Springsteen in his backyard.
So who are your other victims? I mean guests. On the... I had the classic sort of clash of my two passions was the last year at Babe Ruth League. I was kind of showing up at the games, but my heart wasn't in it. I was starting to play the guitar.
Maybe if you had been really good in baseball, you wouldn't have picked up the guitar.
It could have been, because low self-esteem is essential for all rock musicians. You cannot make good rock music without being desperate, you know? By the time I picked the guitar up, I was desperate to find something that I could do.
He was not yet 16, and Bruce was already playing in local clubs on Friday nights, then showing up for baseball on Saturday mornings. It was definitely a conflict of gigs.
Yeah, I got to make my first big decision, and I decide, screw it, I'm not getting up the next morning. So next morning, I'm tucked into my little bed, and I hear banging at the door. My mother comes up and says, oh, they're looking for you to play. Hold on, tell them I'm sick. You know, tell them I can't play. She goes down, she comes back. No, they only have 8. If you don't show up, they're going to forfeit the game, right? So now, so I drag myself out of bed. I get the uniform on. It's 10 in the morning. I get over there, and I'm out in right field. I think I'm just about through. This is my swan song for my career. And bang, somebody hits something. Big pop-up right out in my direction. I'm circling underneath it. It kind of just glances off my glove, cracks me in the skull.
No.
Yeah. And I drop. Bang. And all I hear is, throw it in! Throw it in, man! Throw it in!
Bruce told me he hadn't thrown the ball around since that day, and that he thoroughly enjoyed the diversion. And I told him that I looked forward to the next time. Back home, I kept to my ritual of batting practice in the driveway.